tons of nitrogen per day. It fills two tanks. These two white tanks hold a total of 3,800 tons, roughly 1.2 million gallons of liquid nitrogen. Sounds like a lot, but the tunnel, when it's running at the cold conditions at high speed, we're dumping a ton per second and a half into the tunnel flow to keep it cold. So 3,800 tons can go through in roughly two shifts of operation. They have to stand down and replenish the supply. The other GWIZ number, each ton of nitrogen, $70. So every second and a half, you're kicking off $70 for testing. Plus the electrical energy, plus another, it's roughly $4,300 an hour just to be in the tunnel. If you're not doing anything, you're just sitting there looking at the pretty walls, it's $4,300 an hour. Expensive testing, but it's a safety of flight issue. You come up with a brand new design, you don't want to put a pilot in this brand new design and keep your fingers crossed and hope it flies. If it's not going to work, you want to find out in the wind tunnel and fix it before you put a pilot in it and actually see if it works. So, you know, a typical flight test could be $2-3 million for a single test flight. $2 million test program in here has you in the tunnel for almost a month. So it's a lot of data you can gather and prove your design. So, I forgot the safety moment. So if you hear any alarms, if you're not in front of me, I'm going to be running over you, so just get out of the building the fastest way you can. But we're running in air mode right now, so there's no worries about oxygen deprivation or anything like that. So it's just going to, we're doing actually shakedown. It's the first time we're running in about 2 months after some upgrades. But so again, why do we run cold and high pressure? Well, the tunnel test section, it goes from about this line in the ceiling to the wall and then floor to ceiling. It's an 8.2 by 8.2 foot test section. Typical models, the space shuttle there. But obviously it's not a full size space shuttle. So you can make the model believe it's full size by either pressurizing the air, essentially condensing the air so the air molecules get closer together. You can also do it by getting it colder. Same thing, the air shrinks down. We're going to do a demo later on and I can demonstrate what that does. But what that does, so since we shrunk the model down to fit inside the tunnel, we're also shrinking the air down, condensing the air down to look like it's the same size as the model. So we can get full size data, full scale data out of a model significantly smaller. Let's see, where do we go from here? Transonic. Everybody know what the speed of sound is? No? Good. There'll be a test after this. Speed of sound at sea level, roughly 760 miles an hour. Transonic means typically a tunnel will test just below and just above the speed of sound. So this tunnel can go to Mach 1.2, roughly 900 miles per hour. It's a difficult speed range to test